Yeah, I like React a lot, so that's why I'm even here for the React Ghana meetup. So React, Redux, Standstack. There's recently a library that I discovered, Shatsi, and it's a component UI library, which I really like a lot. It makes development very easy.
So you want to build a video app, voice chat, or even live streaming apps in just minutes? Check out Ziggo Cloud.
Ziggo Cloud is the go-to platform for developers looking to build high-quality communication apps quickly and easily. They offer UI kits and SDKs for video calls, voice calls, live streaming, and even chat apps, all with low code. You don't need to be an expert to create something amazing.
To get started, head over to Ziggo Cloud and sign up. It's quick and easy. And you get 10,000 free minutes to try out their services. Now, the real magic is in their UI kits. These are pre-built tools that make creating apps super simple. Want a video call app? Done. A chat app? No problem. Their low-code solutions save you hours of work. Here's their developer console. Everything is at your fingertips. With Ziggo Cloud, you can integrate powerful features into your apps seamlessly and efficiently. Plus 10,000 free minutes. This is perfect for testing your apps without even spending a dime. Click the link in the description below to get started. To ask software developers what they actually do, let's find out from them what they have to say.
Yeah, my name is Fadal Ibrahim. I'm a software engineer, primarily on the front end, sometimes in the back end. Yeah.
What do you do as a front end developer?
Yeah, so, you know, most people just think of front end as just building interfaces. So that's the first thing I would say, building interfaces, but also the logic that makes the whole interface connect really well. Yeah, so the logic plus the interface.
Okay, I'm Osmole Duji Walasi. I'm a senior software engineer at Nagat, a Dubai-based company.
Okay, what did you as a software engineer?
Alright, so as a senior software engineer, I do DevOps, I do full stack engineering, I make sure systems are built and then the developers are following best practices to get the system built. I do technical writings and stuff like that, yeah.
My name is Francis Echesi. I'm a software engineer and a machine learning engineer.
Okay, what do you do as a machine learning engineer?
So mostly I work with machine learning models. Currently I'm working more with large language models, LLMs. So like Llama, GPT, those things, and then we deploy them for, we integrate them into software applications for different clients.
My name is Dawood. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Sivcash. Siv is a fast and low cost way to send money to your friends.
What are some of the tools you use daily?
Yeah, I like React a lot, so that's why I'm even here for the React Ghana meetup. So React, Redux, Standstack. There's recently a library that I discovered, Shatsi, and it's a component UI library, which I really like a lot. It makes development very easy. Yeah.
Okay, so I do Next.js for front end, Nest for back end. I do Laravel, I do Spring Boot sometimes for back end. And then I use VS Code, I use Keza. Keza is my favorite text editor. I use Keza. I also am a JS person and I do mobile sometimes when the need comes.
So mostly I use PyTorch. That's what most of the models I use based on. And Hugging Face as well. Primary programming language is Python for machine learning. So I think recently I've also picked up LangChain just for building AI agents and integrating them into different software applications.
How did you get yourself into tech?
Yeah, in high school I had a lot of friends that were into tech. At that point it was just normal, just having computers, not really like coding and all of that. So later on we discovered coding and then we started learning together and that.
Okay, what are some of the challenges you face in the tech industry or while getting into the tech industry?
Yeah, I think for me, one challenge I would say is access to mentors, because learning on your own, sometimes you go through a lot of unnecessary things before you come to the right thing. But then if you have a mentor who can just guide you and show you what to learn, what to pick, what not to pick, it makes your whole development life easier.
So, coming into tech, I've been in tech for so many years now, and I started when I was a kid. I had no personal computer, so I was learning from the internet cafe. I had to go to the cafe and then practice whatever I was learning. There was no mentor, there was no teacher, so I learned coding the hard way. I watched some videos, but then I didn't even know there was good content on YouTube to learn or other platforms. So I just tried searching for stuff and I was playing around HTML, CSS until I got to secondary school where I got exposed to JavaScript and then PHP. So by the time I was done with my SHS, I had good fundamentals in JavaScript and then PHP. And then I proceeded to go and read computer science in KNUST. And then this is where I am today.
Why should someone pursue a career in machine learning?
That's a good question. I mean, we can all see the trends of the world right now. It's more AI centric. There's a lot more exposure in the AI machine learning field. And machine learning is sort of the backbone or the beginnings of, you know, AI. It's a subdivision of AI. So I really think it's a viable field to go into if you want to, you know, be part of the developers that sort of shape what the future of the world looks like. I mean, this whole AI race started long ago with the smaller improvements in machine learning that we can see. I don't know if you know anything about machine learning, you've probably written some linear regression models or some classification models. Those are all like the basis for these bigger, more exposed LLMs are based on. So machine learning is really the back end, the backbone of AI in the modern day.
Okay. Please, how did you get yourself into tech, or what inspired you to get into tech?
I think when I was a kid, I used to play around with, I wanted to see my name on the web. So I used to do something like dawoodidris.com, dawoodino.com, and I didn't find any results. Around 2009, I used to go to a cafe and I would do that. And then I'll be like, I one day want to see myself on the web, right? So that was like a fuel in me that just started like curious how things work. I think around like 2012, my mom realized I was really much into, like, I liked computers, and she encouraged me by buying me a laptop. I think that started my journey when I was in high school. Then towards the ending of high school, had an opportunity. She pushed me to IPMC to go and learn. So I learned at IPMC software engineering. So I did that for like a year. Professional diploma in software engineering and all the C++ and stuff. After that, she still insisted that I, you know, go ahead. So I did degree in UDS, information technology. After then, I had mastered my skills. I kept sharing my knowledge with people. I used to organize classes and stuff like that. So that really got me dipped into how tech, you know. Okay.
What are some of the benefits you enjoyed or you've enjoyed in the tech industry?
Well, the tech industry always is the best industry, irrespective of what profession you have. The tech industry is the best industry. It's nice, it's booming, it's growing, keeps growing. I like doing stuff, I like solving problems, and tech is all about solving. Software engineering, for instance, it's all about solving problems. So there is a problem and I'm trying to solve. And that's so much of a satisfaction to me. Yeah.
One piece of advice, will you give it to someone who wants to get into tech?
Get mentors and build a lot. Yeah.
So if you're interested in tech, I recommend you learn by doing. There are several YouTube videos you watch. You can watch a tutorial at the end. You understand everything you watch, but you pick a project and you can't even implement a single thing you learn from that video. So I advise you learn by doing. You actually
okay. What one piece of advice will you give it to someone who is preparing for a job interview in tech?
Well, I would say basically focus on the foundation, right? If you really understand the concepts, if you understand what you're supposed to achieve, not necessarily how you're supposed to do it or what it is you're trying to do, focus on what you're supposed to achieve. If you want to maybe build a house, what's the most important thing? The foundation. You need to get that one right. So for a field or a career like machine learning, you'd honestly want to have a solid foundation in mathematics, statistics, algebra, calculus. You need to get your differentiation on point. You need to get your algebra, your vector manipulation and your matrices, all that stuff. I would say it helps to get a computer science degree, but it's not necessarily the only way. You can always learn on your own. There's a lot of great material online. Most of these universities like MIT, Stanford, most of their lectures are free and available for you on the web. You can just search MIT machine learning course or linear algebra courses, mathematics, anything you need to learn. So when you're done with the basics and mathematics and all that, pick a programming language. The two popular ones these days are Python and C++. Personally, I can write both of them efficiently, but I mostly use Python because of the how popular it is.
What is the state of the tech ecosystem development in Ghana currently?
I think we are doing very well. You can see the likes of MEST and a lot of hubs, right? Whether it's Northern Innovation Lab, whether it's Ghana Tech Lab, And then there was a recent Ghana. I think it was something related to Tech Week, right? That was organized. I think there is a lot of push from Google, from Microsoft, and stuff like that. There are Microsoft MVPs who are doing very well. So I think there is, and this event, we just came to a React, event, right? So I think the state of tech is picking up. People are building company like myself, people are inspired to build companies as well.
Wow. I hope this gives you a glimpse into the award. If you enjoyed this video, then you are going to like the next video.